Hello, and welcome back to another video of Calc Nerd. So today's video is going to be on Tetris. This is just like the classic game of Tetris, where you have to get the blocks just right, and if you get a row, it will delete it. It only deletes the bottom row, and I did use BC's Beta Tetris, so thank you to him for making this program. It is a really solid program. It works really well. It runs very well. And I am learning how to do more stuff on the graph screen, so stay tuned. I will have more graph screen games coming out soon. So let's show you what Program Tetris is. Okay, so I'm going to run Program Tetris. As you can see, it draws the little border for it. It gives you a next piece thing, and it gives you the piece falling down, gives you score, all that stuff. And as you can see, the pieces are falling down. You click up to move like what the piece looks like. So let's say I wanted to get this like that, so you just move it like that. And I tried to put that one over, but I'm not extremely good at Tetris, just so you know. So yeah, it's just like the classic game of Tetris. It's really fun. It's a great game to play as like a time killer, just like the classic game of Tetris, so it's pretty awesome. And now I'm going to show you a little time lapse of me playing Tetris. So as you can see, it's a really solid game of Tetris. It does the deletion of the lines once you get the whole line. Sometimes it does get a little confused though. If you have, let's say, one of those really long lines and you put it straight down, it won't delete all four columns sometimes. Sometimes it'll only just delete one. But that was the way that the game was created. And I did not include the little score part at the end because I am running a little low on bytes. So I have it a little bit optimized from that. So let me now show you how you can program this in on your own calculator so you can play Tetris whenever you'd like. So I'm going to go to Edit, Program Tetris, and you would go to create a new program because you do not have this created yet. So I'm going to Edit, Program Tetris right here. And as you can see, we start off storing some stuff into lists. Remember to get like the fancy brackets here. You would just use second and the parenthesis because second is the yellow button. Gives you the second function of whatever button you're going to press. Same for alpha, which is letters and that kind of stuff. So let's say you wanted the letter C. You click alpha and then program because C is the like tealish color above the program button. So as you can see, we have a lot of coordinates here. Basically what this is doing is it takes one pixel and it has that at the y comma x coordinates, and then it factors in all of this and says, okay, so this one's at -4, 0, so it's down 4 and over 0 from where that is. And I believe that one is actually the square, so it kind of makes sense like that, how that works. So you just have a bunch of those and store them into L1, L2, L3, L4, and L5. So I'll just leave that there just for a second. Okay, 0 store into xmin, 94 store into xmax, 0 store into ymin, and 62 store into ymax. Plots off, fn off, axes off, clear draw. I'm going to point out the fact xmin and xmax, ymin, ymax, that you cannot normally find in the catalog or anywhere else, and I'll show you how to find that in just a second. So just remember that if you need to find any commands, most commands are you're gonna find by just clicking the program button and scrolling over. Like this is where if then and all that stuff is, and over here this is where like output and that kind of stuff is. Because this program is based on the graph screen, you have to set the boundaries and dimensions of that. So you are going to be using second program for a lot of commands. Also, this is where you find like clear draw, line, horizontal, vertical, and also point off, point on, point change, all that kind of stuff. So you will be needing second and program, which is the draw menu. For like the X-Men and X-Max kind of stuff, You are going to need to use the VARS key. So you click VARS, and this will get you to all the like variables in your calculator. So for example, where you find like the Y min, Y max, X min, X max, you go into the window tab and you will find in here, that's where X min, X max, and all that stuff is that you will need. So remember, you just click the VARS key, then you click enter, and there you have all that stuff that you need. And remember, if you can't find a command, odds are that it is going to be in the catalog. So you click second and zero, because yellow button gives you the yellow function, and that will take you into an alphabetical list of almost all the commands. Some of the Windows stuff is not in there. So if you can't find a command, odds are it's going to be in the catalog. Okay, plots off, FN off, axes off, and clear draw. For I, 0, 62, point on at 36, I, 2, point on at 84, I, 2, end. Line at 35, 47, 0, 47, line at 35, 6, 0, 6. Text at 0, 3, quote, BC, then a backtick. Okay. Then text at 7, 7, quote, Tetris. Text at 31, 1, quote, next piece. 0, store into L. Line at 8, 22, 7, 27, 22. Line at 27, 22, 27, 1, or 14, excuse me. Line from 27, 14, 8, 14. Line at 8, 22, 8, 14. Line at 29, 32, 3, 32. Line at 3, 43, 29, 43. Line 29, 32, 29, 43. Yep. Line at 29, 43, 29, 32. Line at 3, 32, 3, 43. Line at 35, 24, 0, 24. And text at 49, 10, quote, line, random 1, 5, store into B, B store into Y. And then a bunch more variables will be stored here. I am just going to recommend to you that at this point, when you get to the text 49, 10, quote, lines, I recommend that you either recheck your code or run the program. To do that, you just exit the program, click program, and so you exit it by second quit, and then you click the program key, you scroll down to Tetris, you run it, and then it will show you the lines, just so you can see that the lines look like it did normally when I was running the game, just to make sure that you typed it in correctly, and you can do that at certain intervals as you would like. And remember, if you get some errors, that is most likely something that you typed. For example, a syntax error is most likely something like a parenthesis or a comma or maybe even a quotation. So that is some stuff that it's just sometimes errors when people are typing in stuff. Don't worry, it happens to me too. So you just have to go back in and change that. So don't worry about it. I mess up all the time when I'm typing in programs. B store into Y, 0 store into W, and 0 store into I. Label 1. If I is equal to 52, go to EN. Text at 57, 1, quote, score, and then a colon, quote, comma, W. W plus 10 store into W, 1 store into P, B store into Y. Random 1, 5 store into B. 17 store into S, and 35 store into T. Text at 41, 10, L. Text at negative 1, 21, 5, quote. And I cannot remember exactly how many spaces that is. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 5 spaces. That's what it is. That's to erase the piece when it says the next piece. And if it is not 5 spaces, then it is 6 spaces. So I apologize if I did get that wrong. But I believe it is 5. If B is equal to 1, L1 store into L6. If B is equal to 2, L2 store into L6. If B is equal to 3, L3 store into L6. If B is equal to 4, L4 store into L6. And there's just a pattern here of 1 is L1, 2 is L2. So you just type that in and do all the if commands. So you can do what I call, like, basically farming commands is what I call it. So what you do is you just do a ton of ifs, and then you do B is equal to, and then you 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and do it in, like, a systematic order rather than doing one line, second line. I just find it's a little more efficient doing that that way. Point on at S, T, 2. Point on at S plus L6 at 1, T plus L6 at 2, 2. Point on at S plus L6 at 3, T plus L6 at 4, 2. Point on at S plus L6 at 5, T plus L6 at 6, 2. If Y is equal to 1, then L1 store into L6, 80 store into Q, and 44 store into R. End. If Y is equal to 2, then L2 store into L6, 76 store into Q, 48 store into R. End. If Y is equal to 3, then L3 store into L6, 76 store into Q, 44 store into R. End. If Y is equal to 4, then L4 store into L6, 44 store into R, 76 store into Q, and end. If Y is equal to 5, then L5 store into L6, 44 store into R, 76 store into Q, and an end. Rand int, 13, 19, store into X, 4 times X store into X. For I, 52, 4, negative 4, get key store into K. Point off at X, I plus 4, 2. Point on at X, X plus L6 at 1, I plus L6 at 2 plus 4, 2. Point off at X plus L6 at 3, I plus L6 at 4 plus 4, 2. Point off at X plus L6 at 5, I plus L6 at 6 plus 4, 2. X plus 4 multiplied by K is equal to 26 and X is less than Q. Minus 4 times K is equal to 24, X is greater than R, store into X. If K is equal to 25, then P plus 1 store into P. So this is the movement command right here. If you were curious, it's the K is equal to 26 stuff. K is for get key normally. So if you were curious about that, I do explain it in some of my other videos. So you can go check those out if you'd like to. I'm just going to keep going with the program here because I'm sure Tetris is a really fun game that lots of people are going to want to play. So, P plus 1 store into P. If P is equal to 5, 1 store into P. If Y is equal to 2, then if P is equal to 3, 1 store into P. If P is equal to 1, then another list here. So I'm not going to like say the list just in case I do get a number wrong. I would like you guys to just kind of read it. Because I don't want to mess you guys up accidentally, because I would feel bad if I did do that. So I'll just let you guys type that kind of stuff in. 76 store into Q, 48 store into R, and end. If P is equal to 2, then another list command right there. 80 store into Q, 40 store into R, and end. Two ends, actually. If Y is equal to 3, then if P is equal to 3, 1 store into P. If P is equal to 1, then another list. And we're storing most of the lists here into L6. So 76 store into Q and 44 store into R. And if P is equal to 2, then another list and store it right into L6. 76 store into Q, 40 store into R, end and end. So with this, all this stuff here is the rotation code. So like when you click the up button, it rotates the piece. So that's what that's for. If Y is equal to 4, then if P is equal to 3, 1 store into P. If P is equal to 1, then right here for L6. 76 store into Q and 44 store into R. And I believe there's an end here. Yep. If P is equal to 2, then another thing store into L6. 80 store into Q and 44 store into R. End. Two ends. If Y is equal to 5, then if P is equal to 1, then another thing store into L6. 44 store into R, 76 store into Q, end. If P is equal to 3, then another thing store into L6, 76 store into Q, and 44 store into R. So it's a lot of repetitive stuff here. So that's basically what the movement code is. It takes up a good portion of this part, so you're getting closer to the end So don't worry. You're getting there. Trust me. It's pretty close. If P is equal to 2, then another thing store into L6. 40 store into R. 76 store into Q. And if P is equal to 4, then that store into L6 and 44 store into R. 80 store into Q. And 3 ends. Point on at X, I, 2. Point on at X plus L6 at 1, I plus L6 at 2, 2. Point on at X plus L6 at 3, I plus L6 at 4, 2. Point on at X plus L6 at 5, I plus L6 at 6, 2. If pixel test at 62 minus I plus 4, X, or pixel test at 62 minus parentheses, L6 at 2 plus I plus 4, L6 at 1 plus X, or pixel test at 62 minus L6 at 4 plus I plus 4, L6 at 3 plus X, or pixel test at 62 minus L6 at 6 plus I, and then add another 4, L6 at 5 plus X, then, so that is a very long command there. And then I minus 4 store into I, go to 2, 2 ends. Label 2, point on at X, I plus 4, point on at X plus L6 at 1, I plus L6 at 2 plus 4, point on at X plus L6 at 3, I plus L6 at 4 plus 4, point on at X plus L6 at 5, I plus L6 at 6 plus 4, 0 store into V, I plus 4 store into I, 0 store into C, 13 store into the dimensions of L6, fill 0 into L6, for J, 36, 84, 4, if pixel test at 62 minus I, J, then C plus 1 store into C. And if pixel test at 62 minus I plus 4, J, then J store into L6, but multiply L6 by J minus 32 divided by 4. So after J is subtracted by 32 divided by 4, then finally store J into L6. End and end. If C is not equal to 13, then go to 1. End. So that is the official end of that part of the program, just so you know. And now we're getting to the part where it just fills in the screen and that kind of stuff. For J, 40, 80, 4, point off at J, I, 2, point off at J, I, end. L plus 1 store into L, W plus 10 store into W, 0 store into L6 at 1, colon, 0 store into L6 at 13. For P, 1, 13, if L6 at P, then point off at L6 at P, I plus 4, point off at L6 at P, I plus 4, 2, and actually, I forgot, there is one last part just to erase your piece, and then we're at the end of the part, and then we have the part where it fills in the screen. Point on at L6 at P, I, 2. Point on at L6 at P, I. Two ends. For theta, I plus 4, 52, 4. For Z, 40, 80, 4. If pixel test at 62 minus theta, z, then point off at z, theta, 2, point off at z, theta, point off at z, theta minus 4, 2, point off at z, theta minus 4, end, go to 1, label en. Now we're at the official end of the program. For I, 35, 43, line at 23, I, 80, I, end. For theta, 0, 8, text at negative 1, actually that is the style of text, 20, 25 plus 6 times theta, sub, quote, game over, at theta plus 1, 1. For z, theta, 50, end. For x, 0, 62, horizontal X, end. Program Tetris. So I'm rerunning the program, and that's when you saw how after it did the whole screen, it cleared it, and then like reran the program. And if you don't want it to do that, and you just want to have to click enter, you just get rid of this last line. So that is the entire program for you to play Tetris. I know it is kind of a long one. It is the longest program so far on this channel. Let me know what you think of it in the comments. It's a really fun game. And let me know your high score. It'd be really neat to hear some of your high scores that you get. You'll probably do better than me because, well, I'm not that great at Tetris. So I hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope you do consider subscribing if you're not. Thank you to anyone who is subscribed for supporting the channel. And I hope to see you in the next few videos. So as always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.